Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. In this video, I'm going to show how we can embed a question that your recipients can answer in an email itself. Typically in Mailchimp, when we create a survey, your recipient will click a link to go to an online survey. But in this case, what we're going to do is embed a single question in the email itself so the respondent can click their answer in the email and have that recorded. Let's go across to Mailchimp. You'll notice I'm in Mailchimp in my demo account at the moment. To add the survey is very simple. What I'm going to do is go to one of my campaigns. So you'll create a campaign as you normally do, an email campaign. I've started to create it just to speed things up a little bit, but you can always watch this video again. So I've defined who I'm sending to, who it's from, the subject line. Now in my content, when I click edit design, this is where we can add the questions. Just to be clear, we don't create a survey first in Mailchimp. We do it in the email itself. So for example, if I want to ask the question underneath, which is your favorite city, for example, so I could click on that block. I'm in the new Mailchimp email builder. You might be in the old one, but the concepts are very much the same. I'm just going to go across. Sorry, that's the wrong thing. There we go. So the question I'm going to ask in this case, I'm in Australia at the moment, so let's pretend my audience is in Australia, but it doesn't matter if in the USA or what your question is. What's your favorite ice cream flavor? Whatever. But I'm going to ask, which is your closest capital city? And you'll notice here that I have the sort of star, then the pipe, then survey. And these are the answers that people will be able to click on. So the question is going to be, which is your closest capital city? And the answers that people will be able to select from are Adelaide, Brisbane, Canberra, etc., etc. And you can just change these for your own purposes. And I will, in the description, I'll leave a link of this video. I'll leave a link where you can come to just copy what I've got on the screen here at the moment. Right, so once you've created your question and your answers, I'm just going to copy that. And in our email builder itself, I can just quite simply paste it in. So your recipients won't see this sort of survey and so on. They'll just see Adelaide, Brisbane, Canberra, Darwin, Hobart, Melbourne, etc., etc., etc. Because if I now preview that, you'll notice that your recipients will get it and they can quite simply click on Sydney, for example, or Perth, or whatever their closest city is, or whatever question you're asking them. So once people receive this email, they'll click on the response and that response is recorded. And that's how easy it is. So what you do now is once you've set up your email, you've previewed it, you're happy, you click continue, and you would send it to all your recipients. Nice and easy. Again, please watch this video again if I'm going a little bit too fast. So you would send. So to see the results, and I'll just show you the results of a survey, just a demo survey I've sent before. So I'll click all campaigns. So to see the results, I would just go to view report to see the report for that specific email I sent. And what you'll notice, it says down here, poll information, view poll results. So I could either click there, or if you don't see this message, just click Analytics 360, the Analytics 360 tab. I'm clicking on that. And if I scroll down, we can now see, and okay, very few responses. This was just a demonstration. One person answered that Brisbane is their favorite city, which was 12.5% of the total responses. Most people liked said Melbourne, four people, which was 50% of total responses, and so on. And what you can also do if you want to, you can drill down into who actually answered Brisbane, etc. If we clicked Brisbane, for example, we would see a list of the email addresses of the people that clicked Brisbane and so on. So you know that that's their closest city then. So far, we created the survey, and again, you can watch again, or you can read the instructions per the link I'll post in the description. We created our campaign with our questions in it. Recipients get it. They just need to click a link. The one thing to know is that once a person clicks the link in the email they receive, their response is recorded, but they are shown a page in Mailchimp saying, thanks for voting. And it doesn't look altogether pretty. So let's just design this. This is just a once-off. Let's just design this. So once people click on that, on their response, they see something a little bit more pretty. So to design this form, to add your logo, for example, we just go into MailChimp, go into your audience, click on View Contacts, click up Sign Up Forms, and again, just reiterating that this is just a once-off you need to do. Click Form Builder. Don't worry that it says Sign Up Form, that's just irrelevant. What we're wanting to do is just make this look a little bit more pretty. Maybe you could click Design It. You know, you can play with a, you know, background color if you really want to. You could hover and I've just clicked Use Image, and you could add your logo if you really want to. And you can go nuts. It just, sorry, just bear with me. It just looks a little bit better. I mean, that looks terrible, but let's ignore that. It just looks a little bit better than this gray and black when people see it, because what they'll see is they'll see your logo, in this case, this weird background color, and they'll see thanks for voting. And that's really it. Please like this video, leave any questions you might have below, subscribe to my channel, but thanks for joining me. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.